Hi everyone, I'm Brian from Channer and Me. Today we're going to do a time trial. We're going to look at making a candle in the candle maker versus the traditional stovetop double boiler method. We're just going to see which one is faster, and not only that, but which one is easier. Remember, our motto is candle making made easy, so let's get into it. We're going to look at the stovetop method. Today we're going to use a portable stovetop. You've got your pot there, you've got a Pyrex jug, you're going to need something to stir it with, stir the wax with, thermometer and the ingredients. We're using the same ingredients for both methods, just so we can compare the results. With the candle maker, you just need the candle maker and the ingredients. Everything else is built in, the thermometer, the stirrer, it's all there ready for you. So we're going to go ahead and load the wax into each of our methods and press the go button, and we're off. So the important thing to note is the candle maker has all the temperatures preset, so we're going to melt this wax to around 75 degrees Celsius, and same in the double boiler method. The difference is the candle maker is just going to automatically melt to that temperature, which you can see after a time elapsed of around 10 and a half minutes, it's done. So this is the perfect temperature now for adding your fragrance. You can see on the double boiler method, we're still waiting for the wax to melt. In fact, so you can see a lot of flakes still in there. Whereas we're about to pour the fragrance in now into the candle maker, and then we'll press that middle flashing button, which will put us into a stirring mode, and that's going to automatically stir the wax for you for 2 minutes, really binding the fragrance molecules into the wax. So we've finally got the wax the temperatures ready to add the fragrance in our double boiler, and we've had to manually stir that for 2 minutes. So the double boiler method, you've really got to attend to it a lot. You've got to pay attention and you've got to be on task, whereas with the candle maker, you can easily be doing other things around the house. The system is semi-automated. It's just gonna wait for you. It'll even wait for you to come and pour the candle. It'll hold at that pour temperature, which we're pouring now at around 21 and a half minutes. It'll just wait for you to come back and pour it. It'll actually wait for up to 2 hours. The double boiler won't wait. It'll boil dry and you've got a real problem. So we're still checking, and now we've finished making our candle in the candle maker. But now we're on the double boiler, we're waiting for the temperature to cool down. So you can see the candle making appliance is just so more efficient at regulating the temperatures in the candle making process. So the candle maker is done. All we need to do is put a squirt of detergent into the pitcher there and give it a rinse out with some warm water, and that's our job done. Put it away for next time. Finally, about 10-12 minutes later, we're ready to pour with the double boiler method. Then we've got to clean all those individual bits and pieces of equipment and put it away. We could have made easily 2 or 3 candles in the same time with the candle maker appliance. It would have taken longer if we used 2 or 3 candles in the double boiler. But there you go. There's a time trial comparison. There's what the candles look like. You can see they've both got a smooth, creamy finish on them. They'll both perform about the same. But I think you'll agree that one method was a lot easier, more efficient, and delivered a great result. Let us know what you think in the comments. Which method do you prefer? And thanks for watching.